Good afternoon, parishioners and friends of the Lord. Again, welcome to Our Lady's Chapel, and let us begin in God's presence. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we are mindful of the Lord's presence, we reflect on our opening antiphon today, which is in keeping with the gospel message. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my stronghold. Whom should I dread? And so as we remember our needs, we ask the Lord to listen to us, to forgive us if we have hurt someone, and we pray together. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Today, one of the saints to be honored is the Jesuit saint, Saint Joseph of Antioquia, originally from Spain, and spent all his active life in Latin America, working for the people. Pour out, we pray, O Lord, your grace upon us, that by the example of Saint Joseph of Antioquia, your priest, as faithful servant of the gospel, and having become in all things to all, we may strive to gain for you, brothers and sisters in the love of Christ. And this we ask through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
First book of Kings. The brook near where Elijah was hiding ran dry because no rain had fallen on the land. So the Lord said to Elijah, "Move on to Zarephath in Sidon and stay there. I have designated a widow there to provide for you." He left and went to Zarephath. And as he arrived at the city, at the entrance of the city, a widow was gathering sticks there. He called out to her, "Please bring me a small cup of water to drink." She left to get it, and he called out after her, "Please bring along a bit of bread." She answered, "As the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked. There's only a handful of flour in my jar and a little oil in my jug. Just now I was collecting a couple of sticks to go in and prepare something for myself and my son. When we have eaten it, we shall die." Elijah said to her, "Do not be afraid. Go and do as you propose, but first make a little cake and bring it to me. Then you can prepare something for yourself and your son. For the Lord, the God of Israel, says, 'The jar of flour shall not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, until the day when the Lord sends rain upon the earth.'" She left and did as Elijah had said. She was able to eat for a year, and Elijah and her son as well. The jar of flour did not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, as the Lord had foretold through Elijah. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response, let your face shine on us. Let your face shine on us. When I call, answer me, O my just God, you who relieve me when I am in distress. Have pity on me and hear my prayer. Men of rank, how long will you be dull of heart? Why do you love what is vain and seek after falsehood? Let your face shine on us. Know the Lord does wonders for the faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him. Tremble and sin not. Reflect upon your beds in silence. Lord, let your face shine on us. O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine on us. You put gladness into my heart more than when grain and wine abound. Lord, let your face shine on us. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia. Let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Our reading today is from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, what can it season? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out, trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. No, it is set on a lampstand where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father." The Gospel.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our friends in the Lord, in the second paragraph of Matthew's Gospel, states clearly to the followers of the Lord, the people he has gathered, that their actions, the way they live their daily lives, should be drawing them closer to Christ. Today, 2020, we, the present followers of the Lord, how might we transform the world in which we live, with the gifts God has given to each one of us? Number two, how are we doing? Do I try to use my gifts to help someone in need for the glory of God? In doing so, you, like Saint Joseph of Antioch, will be a light to people around us, to those who need to see the good news of the Lord, to see it in action, not just to hear it. As we prepare to offer our gifts of bread and wine, let us bring our special intentions to the Lord. And today's Mass is being honored for Josephine Calararo, deceased. And let us pray for people who are hurting today, people who are lonely, maybe somebody you know in a hospital or a nursing home. And we ask the Lord to be mindful of them and to bless us as we reach out to each of them. Bless you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Bless you, Lord God of all creation, for For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine worked in human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive this. Please sacrifice we offer to drink. My friends, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to our loving God.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all God's holy church.
As we bring this offering to your altar, Lord, and follow the examples of Blessed Joseph and Tessia, we offer your divine majesty with deep affection all we possess and ourselves with it for your greater glory. And this we ask through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up our hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
For you are, it is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their orphans are wonders of your might. In your mind, mercy, you give order to their fate. To their endurance, you grant them firm resolve. And as their struggle and their victory is yours through Christ the Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, as with the host of angels we cry out without end and acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy, holy Lord, God, power, and might.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed
is
he
who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim
and
your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until
you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring unto the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Timothy our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And let us especially remember those close to us, family members, friends, also those who have no one to pray for them. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, Blessed Apostles, all your saints, Saint Joseph and Tessia, who will please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, and through them to each of us, my peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but look on our faith, and grant to us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And let us, friends, offer peace to those near you. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, with faith in your love and mercy, we eat your body and drink your blood. Let it not bring us condemnation, but health in mind and body. For this is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
And in the quiet of your heart, let us reflect. My Jesus, I believe you are really here in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you more than anything in the world. I hunger to feed on your flesh. But since I cannot receive communion at this moment, feed my soul spiritually. I unite myself to you now, as I do when I actually receive you. Never let me drift away from you. Amen.
Amen.
Where I am, there also will my servant be, says the Lord. Let us pray. Through the power of the sacrament we have received, Lord Jesus, lavish upon us the spirit of kindness with which you fill Blessed Saint Joseph Mantasia, that people may sense that in the least of your brothers and sisters you are also near. And this we ask through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us be at peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you all.